We're here. We're live. Good to be back. It felt like Nick and I broke up there for a while. We were gone for a couple of games, but we're back here. Welcome to Junior B Lacrosse as the Point Edward Pacers take on Windsor Clippers. We're out at center floor. And the Pacers looking for a W tonight. Hello, everybody. Welcome from the Point Edward Memorial. Really, say that five times fast. Point Edward Memorial Arena. We're live. And tonight, Noah Young and Mark Schmidt are your officials. Oh, that's good to know. If the Pacers win the next three games, they will make the playoffs. So I guess that's good to it's good to have goals. St. Louis can do it to anybody, can my friend.
Congratulations to St. Louis Blues for sure. Having a great game. I was watching it last night. It was good. Lots of excited fans. And now Pacers here tonight. It's going to be a busy weekend for the Pacers. We'll be back here on Saturday and Sunday. And that will, I guess, dictate what may or may not happen. Is he in right now?
No, Elijah's in net.
Okay. Confirming our goalie here right now, Elijah Trudeau in for the Pacers. All right, Windsor with the ball, bringing it down for the Pacers to challenge. And the Pacers knock it away. But Windsor picking it back up immediately. Number 14, Corey Kruster.
Sorry about the technical difficulties there. Audio. But there's the first goal against the Pacers. 1-0, 17:39 on the clock. And back out to center floor. So thanks to our sponsors who brought us here to bring you this live broadcast. Pacers with the ball. Hand off to bring it down. Number 21, Nate Armstrong.
Clippers goal by number 24, Lane Wallace. Assisted by number 10, Nathan Solaris. And number 18,
loose ball back out to center floor. And a shot, a last attempt shot as the shot clock runs out for the Pacers. Now, Windsor coming down to challenge the Pacers. A pass from center. Pass out front. A shot, and it's another one. Well played by Windsor. Passing, certainly a big part of this sport. And recalling from being the last few games that we broadcast, Pacers were struggling with their passes. We'll see if they've improved on that here tonight. As we mentioned earlier, they need the next three games to make themselves into the playoffs. 2-0 with 16:52 on the clock. 12, 9, number 12, for Windsor with that goal. If you're watching us on YouTube, we would appreciate you clicking the share button and sharing the link to our broadcast on your social media. And for anybody from Windsor watching or out of town from Point Everett watching, hello, thanks for being here. At center floor right now, Windsor with the ball. Loose ball picked up quickly by Windsor again, trying to get inside the dotted line, so to speak. And it's back outside into the center floor. Windsor with the ball. Pick up the rebound, a shot, and it's a goal at the last second. Like half a second on that clock, I would say. But officials calling it a goal. 3-0 right now. First period already. And first period and already. Four minutes in. Blaine Wallace with the goal for Windsor there. Fighting to get their first goal and first mark on the board here, but not having much success. 5 minutes into this first period. Again, 3-0 right now. Windsor down challenging Pacers. And I'm shot and blocked this time by Trudeau. Jacob Knowles out in front of Windsor. Grabs the ball, looking to get inside. Pass back to Jack McCulley and takes a shot. Windsor picks it up to come down hard here. Pass out front. Whistle to continue on here. Pacers. Logan Scott with the ball, carrying it in. Looking to get by Windsor here. McGregor with the ball. Back out. Pass again. Pass to Knowles and missed and picked up by Windsor goalie. Back into the Pacers area. And we're going to see our first penalty of this game. It looks like number 11, Max Musico. Didn't catch what for, but we'll find out in a moment.
Number 11, Trudeau. Two minutes
for interference to Max Musico of the Pacers. Not the time Not good timing for the Pacers to have a penalty when it's already 3-0, and a shot blocked by
Pacers
Trudeau.
Penalty to number 11, Max Musico. 2 minutes for interference. Time of the penalty, 12:59. Musico, 2 minutes for interference at 12:59.
Nate Armstrong out front with the ball for the Pacers. 13 seconds on the shot clock. Pacers still trying to get on the board here, and now with a penalty, that's not going to help them out. Shot clock runs out. Passed off to Zane Dulp, who's the first scorer for the Windsor tonight. Came from Zane. There's a battle for the ball, and Windsor wins the fight. And now, a little set up pass in here to go for a shot, blocked by Trudeau. Get out of the way, ref. Brave men. Oh, knocked away here. Control of the ball. 15 seconds on the clock. Another shot blocked by Trudeau. We're seeing well, there's a lot of pushing going on out there. I'm predicting some things. The pass out front and missed, and this is picked up by Windsor, and as we mentioned before, this is something that the Pacers have needed to work on, was catching the pass. Windsor inside the blue line. And a shot and another goal. 4-0. 10:36 remaining in this first period of Pacers lacrosse action. Coming to you live from the Point Edward Memorial Arena. And it is now 4-0. Jackman Schooley with the goal for Windsor. Pacers off to a bad start here. 10:25 to go in the first period.
Clippers goal by number 18, Jackman Schooley, assisted by number 13, Max Payton.
Pacers back out in full force now. I thought we might have saw a penalty there, but how about no?
Illustrious former prime minister, did you think that?
Pacers coming down to challenge Windsor here. They've got to find some kind of a plan here. Brett Vince out on the floor now with the Pacers. And a breakaway attempt by number 2, Bailey Roth. Blocked by Eliza. And it's getting rough out there, folks. Ethan Parkhouse knocked down hard, but it didn't stop him. He kept going. Max Musico with the ball. Over to McGregor. McGregor. Pass off from Knowles. And a shot down low, and it slides in. It looked like it was blocked, but it kind of rolled in there after. So that's the one the Pacers need to get in this game. Now they're going to need 3 more to stay in the game right now. 4-1 in favor of the Windsor Clippers. And again, as we mentioned earlier, the Pacers need tonight and the next 2 games, if they are to see any part of the playoffs.
13, 77,
and Brett Vince
goal by number 13, 77, Jacob Knowles, and number 11, Max Musico. Time of the goal, 9:06. Hints from Knowles and Musico at 9:06.
There we go, Knowles and Musico with the assist there. With Brett Vince, number 13. Out of the center, number 24, coming in a shot and blocked by Trudeau. Windsor picks up the rebound, looking for another opportunity here. Getting organized. Long shot, pass right out front. Nice attempt, but no goal there. Connor McManus is Windsor right now. Say thanks to our friends at Hughes Intelligence for being one of our strong supporters here. Our supporters, another goal for the Clippers. Makes it 5-1 now. We're certainly hearing some chirping down below us there in the benches. That's usually a prediction. Pacers penalty. 2 minutes for something.
Stevens, 2 minutes
for high sticking, and amongst all that, another goal for Windsor, 6-1. This is not how you like to start off a first period. Back out to center floor right now. Thankful to all of our sponsors. We mentioned Hughes Intelligence and Active Ears, also a strong supporter. And of course, our friend Fabian Jagu from the co-operators here in Sarnia. We appreciate their support. Windsor in control of the ball. Goalie comes out to get involved. The penalty going to Knowles, and he's not liking that. He's arguing that the goalie came out. And it's the time I'd love to be a fly on the shoulder of the referee receiving the verbal conversation. Another goal. 7-1 now. Noel still having conversations with the referee about what was going on, and we saw our line one ref, Mark Smith, having conversation with the bench, and seems to be an ongoing conversation. Here we go, back center floor. Pacers win the ball.
24-3. That's 12 goal players. 8-23. Clippers goal by number 8.
Brett Barnes.
Where's number 8?
Brett Barnes.
Assisted by number 24, Blaine Wallace, and number 3, Jack Dunn. Time of goal, 6:26.
Interesting there. Brett Barnes and Jack Dunn, former players for the Pacers, involved in that last goal for Windsor. Seven to one, 5.5 minutes to go. As we're checking our stats here, we're seeing visitors from New Westminster, BC, watching us right now in Sarnia. Say hello to our friends in Exeter. Sarnia, of course, and there's London, Ontario, and Sook, BC, Fergus, Ontario, Toronto, some from the United States as well. Thank you to all of you who are stopping by here and joining us. Mountain View, California is watching us too. That's nice. Welcome to the broadcast. Pacers inside the blue line. Jacob Knowles with a pass off. Looking for a hard shot. 21, Nate Armstrong with a failed attempt at a goal. 7-1. A long way to go if the Pacers are going to continue and have any hope of making it into the playoffs. As we said, they need to win all three games to make it. Windsor with the ball. Out to number 3. He's working hard getting inside, and still a block by Trudeau. Jack Dunn. And a bit of a love tap back from Trudeau on that one as he came in. A little respect, I guess. And if you're watching from our website, we would encourage you to take time to look at the other things that are available on the Video Show Network and the other things that we live stream as well. Pleasantries from the bench. Long pass over to loose ball.
Pacers fans, don't forget you can follow the Pacers all the time. Streaming live on the Video Show Network at TVSN.ca.
Pacers. Peyton Cox with the ball. Next opportunity for the Pacers. Something's got to change here with only 3 minutes left to go in this first period of Junior B lacrosse. Out front and a missed pass, and again picked up by Windsor. Coming down hard over to 23. Blair Cosgrove. Pacers now back to the Windsor zone. 20 seconds on a shot clock here. Looking to make another mark. Nate Armstrong with a pass out front. Another shot and attempt, and there's another goal. And that is how they need to keep playing. The pass is necessary, but it's got to be caught. So there you go. Jacob Coughlin with the goal there for the Pacers.
Pacers goal by number 16, Jack Coughlin. Assisted by number 77, Jacob Knowles, and number 21, Nate Armstrong. Coughlin from Knowles and Armstrong at 236.
8-2 now.
Clippers goal by number 20, Jonathan.
2 minutes to go.
Assisted by number 12, Zane Dowell. Time of goal, 2:22. Jenkins from Dowell at 2:22.
Number 16 down hard here. Jacob Coughlin. Trainer coming out to the floor. Assumptions happening at the moment, but we'll.
Don't forget, you can get your tickets for tomorrow, or Saturday and Sunday's games tonight. All you have to do is go over to our ticket booth to pick those up. Thanks to our ticket sponsors, Blue Water Power, keeping energy flowing in Sarnia Lambton. Pacers bench minor being served by number 8, Cyrus Snedler. A bench minor assessed to the Pacers being served by number 8, Cyrus Snedler.
So bench minor being served by Pacers. And Jacob Coughlin walked off the floor and seems to be okay considering. And shot blocked by Trudeau. From Coyote 103, the last minute of the play sponsor here. You can check them out online, coyote103.com. A shot coming from McGregor with no luck and seems to be alone down here. But he come out of it. He's looking to get another shot off with 20 seconds on the clock. And the ball is dropped and picked up by Windsor. Bringing it down is Blaine Wallace. Eight to two. And that's the end of our first period here at the Point Edward Memorial Arena. 8-2 in favor of Windsor Clippers right now. So Pacers will need to have some conversation in the locker room. Sorry, 9-2, I should say. Last second goal. 9-2 at the end of this period, and we'll see if the Pacers come out and change things up. They're going to need to do something here. Don't forget, if you're near us here at Point Edward Memorial Arena, there's still time to come in and get your tickets to come out and watch the game live. We appreciate you watching us, but there's nothing like watching it in real life. And we'd love to have you here as part of our Pacer fan group. We'll take a short break, and we'll be back in about 8 minutes. Stay with us. All right, welcome back. What's the change? Sorry. So Pacers back out to center floor against Windsor as they start 9-2 into this second period, and Keegan Bell now in between the pipes in front of the mesh for the Pacers. Number 13 for the Pacers, chasing the ball to bring it back down. Knowles up front with the ball and a shot, no goal. It goes down hard as well. Windsor looking to get their first goal against Keegan Bell. Let's see what changes out here for the Pacers this time around. Shot clock runs out. Back the other way. Shot and blocked by Windsor. Jacob McClellan. Don't pass it off. Pacers with the ball and over to Knowles. Knowles inside the blue line and a shot up front, and there is a goal. And that's the kind of plays the Pacers are going to have to make if they want to get in the game of catch-up. 9-3 right now. Up from center floor. McCulley with a goal for the Pacers. And Pacers looking to get back into this game. And if they can make those passes and catch them, that has been a weakness we've talked about up here in the media booth. Is lots of passing going on, but it doesn't mean anything if you're not catching it. Up front, Knowles with a pass off. Pass that has helped the Pacers. Another missed pass. Windsor will pick it up. Those are the opportunities you can't afford to throw away. Certainly not when you're behind by six. 15 seconds on this shot clock for the Pacers, or Windsor, sorry. Going to get inside and pushing through hard, but not happening this time. Mm-hmm. Dunn with a pass off over to Armstrong. Here's Nate with a shot. Another block by Windsor. There's a shot blocked by, saved by the bell. I haven't said that in a while. I know it's slacking off in my humorous commentating quotes. Yeah, they're laughing up at me here in the media booth. Pacers, number 15. Logan Scott gets a shot off, but blocked again by Windsor. Pacers get the ball to bring it down. Looking for another challenge against Windsor. Bert Thorpe. Nice attempted shot, but off the top post. Picks up the rebound, but no goal. Thanks again to all of our sponsors who have been supporting us here today. Hughes Intelligence. Thanks, Barry. And our friends at Active Years. Fabian Jagu and Associates as well. And the Tall Ships coming to Sarnia August 9th, the 11th, the Tall Ships. And did I mention Fabian Jagu? I think I did, yeah. Sponsors that bring you this live broadcast make it possible here. Grateful to them. 9-3, 13:35 remaining in the second period of Junior B lacrosse. And the men in blue ...9-3, and a 2-minute penalty to the Pacers. Holding.
Pacers penalty to number 11, Max Musico. 2 minutes for holding. Time of infraction, 13.
Sneaky passing, a shot, and picks up the rebound shot twice. And still no goal in there. Blocked well by Keegan Bell. Shot clock runs out for Windsor. Next opportunity here for the Pacers. 12:44 to go in the second period. Fight hard down there behind the Windsor net to get the ball away. The shot clock runs out first.
Yeah.
Pacers with the ball. Number 14 right now. Taking a hard hit from Bailey Rolfe. A.J. Mara getting beat up hard here, but he holds on to the ball. Looking to take a shot. He makes the shot. The last attempt with the clock running out, but both teams certainly making lots of noise. And a penalty to number 24, Blaine Wallace. 4 minutes. Checking from behind. It's 4 minutes there. So Blaine Wallace. Moles with the ball out front. Over to Dunn. Dunn with the pass off. Tried to sneak it in. From Logan Scott trying to get by. Long pass down and a shot. No. Thought about it twice. Wasn't ready. 18 seconds. To go. There's another one. Hard plan. Paid off there now, making it 9-4. And the Pacers headed towards catching up, but still five away from tying the game here. Wherever you're watching from, we thank you for watching us here on the Video Show Network. And we thank our friends from the Junior B, the Lacrosse Pacers, for allowing us to bring you this broadcast. Pacers win the fight at center floor and take it down. Logan Scott from Jacob Knowles on that last goal.
Pacers power play goal by number 15, Logan Scott. Assisted by number 77, Jacob Knowles. Time for goal, 10:25. Scott from Knowles at 10:25.
Fastest game on 2 feet. Knowles gets in the way of the ball and tries to make a shot off, but it doesn't happen. Nate Armstrong now getting in the way. His captain for Windsor, Chad and Ted.
Oh, nice pick.
That's going to leave a mark. And here comes Nate with a shot. And he gets... Got a little fancy with the bend it around the back of my neck shot. All right. Knowles with the ball. Pacers looking to get in a score here. Knowles picks up a rebound. Shot wide to the left. And it's Windsor's turn. Shot and no goal. Penalty in 10 seconds about to run out for Windsor to give them back in full force. It was a 4 minute opportunity for the Pacers. It didn't quite work. Except for the one. Running hard back down. Full force now for Windsor. You just don't mess with the... What did I miss? You just don't mess with the goalie. That's just... I don't understand. No penalties here. Interesting.
Really letting them play it out.
Goalie switch now. Chase Cosgrove will go in for Windsor, number 51. Yeah.
Clippers goalie exchange now in goal number 51, Chase Cosgrove. They chased one out, and now they got another one in.
This is going to get nasty here. Windsor with a pass back out front of center floor. Thinking about what to do here. Connor McManus out on the floor here. Max Payton. Zane Dalt. He scored earlier as well. Clock, shot clock runs out here. Pacers now with the opportunity. 9-4 and 7:20 to go in this second period. A shot blocked. Pacers still with the ball, picking up the rebound. Dunn out front over to Knowles. Another shot from Knowles and blocked well. And they pressed through, and there's another one. The game of catch-up is getting a little narrower here for the Pacers at 9-5. While the clock runs out, they're still in the game. There's still opportunity here.
17
Gavin McGregor, unassisted for the Pacers.
Pacers goal by number 17, unassisted. Gavin
McGregor. Go back out the center floor here.
Timely goal, 7:02. McGregor at 7:02, unassisted.
It's getting rough out there. We can the rumbling below us here in the media booth. Pacers looking to form up here. Lose the passing game there. And there's another one. It's now 10-5, so they're catching up two steps forward and three steps back, or how does that work? 10-5. 6:25 to go in the second period. Hello, everybody, if you're just joining us, watching from wherever you're watching from. If you're watching on our YouTube channel, we'd appreciate you clicking the like button. And on our website, take some time to surf around our website and enjoy the different things that we offer at the Video Show Network.
Clippers goal by number 12, Zane Dolph, assisted by number 6, Caden Brennan. Time for goal, 6:25.
Dolph and Brennan. Dolph with the goal, assisted by Brennan. You hear that from our arena announcer, Nick from Coyote 103. If you're a country fan, you want to check out Coyote 103 on their website. Coyote103.com. Inside the blue line here with Windsor. And doing what they do best at passing and making opportunities for themselves. I missed one there, and the shot clock will go away. Pacers with their next opportunity to step up their game to get in this game. They're five away from tying things up. They've got some work to do on their journey here. They've got to win tonight and the next two games to even make it to the playoffs. And that's how they're going to get there. If they do stuff like that, it's now 10-6. There is still hope. And the trick, honestly, here is to stay out of the penalty box and catch those passes. A lot of those passes have been missed by the Pacers here as we go up to center floor. 5:17 to go in the second period. Wild loose ball. And Windsor finds it. No pass. Windsor has the ball.
Remember, Pacers fans, you still have time to get your 50-50 tickets. The table is open. Make sure you get your 50-50 tickets and get in on the winning.
Pressing hard to get inside, but good luck for Windsor there. Headed the other way. Dylan Lavoy with the ball for the Pacers right now. Knowles out on the floor, along with Logan Scott. Brett Vince. There's a shot and a block from Nate Armstrong. Blocked by Cosgrove. You see some of our friends from Petrolia online watching us as well. Hello. Thanks for stopping by. Down. There's a penalty coming there. Appreciate you watching us here. You're on the Video Show Network. Peyton Cox having some words and conversation and chatter happening down in front of us here. Our producer getting ready with his camera in case there's some action. Lots of conversations happening here. Penalties all around. A 5-minute penalty for Windsor, 2 for Pacers. 3:44 to go at 10. So a 2-minute for high stick and a 5-minute for high stick.
To number 77, Jacob Knowles, 2 minutes for high sticking. Knowles, 2 minutes for high sticking. Clippers penalty to number 4, Colton Kogelon, 4 minutes for high sticking.
5 minutes for high sticking.
Kogelon, 5 minutes for high sticking. Time of the penalties.
So, 4-on-4 here. Brett Vince with a pass over to Dunn. Or McCauley, sorry. Cosgrove picks up. And Windsor's bring the challenge down to the Pacers as they're inside, just inside the blue line now. A nice passing, number 12 with the ball. Zane Dolph, who's scored earlier.
A few times, yeah.
And there's a block. Dare I say, saved by the bell again. Number 55, Peyton Cox going into the penalty box as well. It's not the time to do this, fellas, when you're down 10-6. Four away from tying things up. 2:40 on the clock here. 2 minutes for slashing to Peyton Cox.
Pacers penalty to number 55, Peyton Cox. 2 minutes for slashing. Cox, 2 minutes
Dylan Lavoy
for
with the ball.
At 2:42.
Waiting for support to arrive. Logan Scott back on the floor. Oh. And we'll say thank you to our sponsors once again. This time we want to say hi to our friend Philly Cheese Jake's. If you're hungry, he'll fill your hunger. You can visit him online at phillycheesejakes.com. Thanks, Jake Chersky. Back at it here now. Just under two to go. 2 minutes at 2 minutes. Another shot down low. Blocked by Bell again. And the whistle to carry on. Pacers out front looking to pass. Knowles around and a shot hard. Blocked. An interesting block by Cosgrove. Whistle's gone. Getting things fixed up here. Wherever you're watching from, we appreciate you being here. Hope you're enjoying the broadcast and Video Show Network. We do lots of live streaming is what we do. Fabian Jagu, one of our supporters of Fabian Jagu and Associates from the co-operators. Last minute to play for us is brought to you by the Tall Ships of Sarnia, coming here August 9th to the 11th. A hard one knocked down. Number 9 went down hard. Connor McManus. Ten to six right now. A 5 minute penalty to the Pacers. Five minutes for boarding.
All right.
Lots of chatter up here in the
Pacers penalty to number six.
Media house.
Brent Thorpe. 5 minutes for boarding. Thorpe, 5 minutes for boarding at 41 seconds.
And last chance in this period for the Pacers, and that'll go away. Clock runs out to end this period. Second period, Windsor still ahead by 4 at 10-6.
At the end of the second period, the score is Clippers 10, Pacers 6.
We'll invite you to check out our website if you're watching us at tvsn.ca. And maybe you've got some events you'd like live streamed. We'd like to talk to you about that. You can send us an email to info@tvsn.ca. Tell us what you're thinking. I'm sure we can accommodate live streaming your event for you. And again, the end of this period brought to you by the Tall Ships of Sarnia. Tall Ships coming to Sarnia August 9th to the 11th. And we'll take a short break and we'll be back in about 8 minutes' time. We'll talk to you then. All right, welcome back at the end of the second period. Going into the third period, 10-6. Penalty still on the board.
Let's get ready for some lacrosse.
38 shots on goal for the Pacers against their 37. Nick from Coyote 103 brought his sense of humor today. You can listen to them live at Coyote103.com. And I guess the Raptors are winning. That's a good thing. I guess it depends who you are.
I thought I was going to play Send in the Clowns when the referees came.
I'm going to have to cover up my microphone so we're not picking up the rack gallery here. All right, getting ready for period number three. 20 minutes on the clock to go. Will the Pacers turn it around? They've got to win tonight the next two games to make it into the playoffs. Waiting for number 51. There he is. Chase Cosgrove. And here we go. Pacers with the ball. Knowles. Gets out front and a shot. No goal. Safe shot there. Oh, are you kidding me right now? Wow. Did you see that? Did we catch that? We were slow to move the camera there, but the ball was rolling down to Elijah Trudeau, who's back in the goal. And missed it, and it just rolled by him and went in. That's an embarrassing goal, for sure. 11-6 now. And a four-minute penalty coming to Windsor here. Pacer zone now. And that goal accredited to the goalie of the Clippers, number 51, Chase Cosgrove. Another goal. from the Pacers here. 11-7 right now. Still 7-11?
You haven't gotten there yet. You should try it.
Somebody's hungry. Back out to center floor, Jack McCauley from Jacob Knowles for that Pacers goal. They're headed in the right direction. Be a little closer if it wasn't for that last one given away.
Pacers goal by number 10, Jack McCauley, assisted by number 77, Jacob Knowles. Time of goal, 18:05. McCauley from Knowles at 18:05.
Block shot from Trudeau coming from Windsor. Windsor still inside the blue line. Looking to get off another shot here to get further away from the Pacers. As they work at getting caught up here. 16:45 to go.
Okay.
39:50.
Getting excited over the $39.50 50-50 here tonight. Loose ball picked up by Windsor's goalie. And he takes a hit. I guess if you're going to come out, you're going to come out and play. Pacers down in the Windsor zone. 16 minutes to go. 15 seconds on our shot clock. And a missed pass again. I keep seeing that.
Pacers fan, check your 50-50 tickets for a grand total of $39.50 this evening. The winning 50-50 ticket.
There's another goal.
12-7
now. Pacers felt getting closer, but didn't last long.
15:33
to change things around here.
Waiting for you at the corner table.
So don't forget the 50 cents. Conversation happening here. We got a timeout call here. Thank you. quite sure what happened there. They don't tell us everything. 12-7, 15:33 to go. Hello. You are watching Junior B lacrosse action hosted by the Point Edward Pacers here at the Point Edward Memorial Arena. Broadcasting live on our the Video Show Network channel. Two minutes for illegal equipment. Interesting. We'll have to investigate that one later. And struggle for the ball and picked up by Windsor.
Clippers penalty to number 17.
Caden Brennan.
2 minutes for illegal equipment.
Another one for the Pacers right now. That'll put them up a little closer. But still not quite where they need to be with time running out. 14:36 on the clock. Wherever you're watching from, we hope you enjoy the broadcast. Brought to you by our sponsors. Say thank you to Hughes Intelligence for supporting us. Not just here, but the other things we do. Active Ears from Christine Fiji. 14:36. Pacers down to Windsor zone again, looking to even the score. Some passing happening out front here. A shot down low, no goal. Picked up by Windsor. Number 23, Blair Cosgrove knocked down hard. Caden Brennan will hand it off. Max Payton now, he'll pass it off. And 5-on-5 now. Penalties run out off the board. And shot blocked by Trudeau. And the Pacers taking a 2 minute penalty. For cross-checking to Caden Brennan. Oh, sorry. Bert Thorpe. Apologies. Pacers with the ball with 5 seconds on a shot clock. Something's got to happen here. Comes her goalie, Cosgrove. Hands it off. Solaris with the ball. Pacers with the ball and 11:30 on the clock to tie things up. They've got work ahead of them. Windsor's certainly not slouching against them. And a shot off at the end of the shot clock. Windsor opportunity. Shot, no goal. Windsor picks up the rebound. Number 8, Brett Barnes, formerly of the Pacers, with the ball. Now loose ball and a shot. Picked up by the Pacers. Passed off. Nate Armstrong going in for a shot. And a miss just the right side of the bowl. Shortcomings for the Pacers right now. And another one coming from Windsor will make it 13-9. Opportunity slipping away. And we will be back here on Saturday. 7 o'clock, we'll be broadcasting live. Philly Cheese Jake's a friend of ours. He'll fill your hunger every time. Go to phillycheesejakes.com. Pacers will host the Guelph Bengals. 7 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. We'll be here broadcasting. I won't be here as your commentator. Somebody else will be filming, but we will have the broadcast, so mark that on your calendar. And this period's now half over with only 10 minutes to go. No penalties on the board, and the Pacers would probably do well to keep it that way for the rest of this game at 13-8. It's not where you want to be at this point of the game. When you're winning, the clock ticks slow, and when you're behind, it counts too fast. Nate Armstrong, a long shot as the shot clock runs out. Windsor with their next opportunity. Number 12, Ethan Parkhouse. Seven hitting the showers. Got two 2-minute penalties going on here. find out here in a moment. You're watching the Video Show Network as we broadcast live from the Point Edward Memorial Arena. For sure, two remaining games will be here on Saturday at 7 o'clock and Sunday at 4. We appreciate you sharing the link around to your lacrosse fans. So Isaac Dockstader stick goes to the goalie. There's an unsportsmanlike in there. Another one from Windsor makes it 14-8. They're making it tougher on themselves, six away from a tie. 8:06 left in this final period. Again, we'll say thank you to our friends from the Tall Ships. Tall Ships coming to Sarnia August 9th to the 11th, a part of a big celebration. The Tall Ships, Blue Otter Border Fest, which we will also be at, and Artscape will be at all of those.
2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct and a 10-minute misconduct.
Some conversation with our referees, making some decisions here. Well, see momentarily what's happening. Your 2 minute penalty here for the Pacers. It's not the time for this. Away. Nate Armstrong loses it there and gets picked up, and here it comes. And a block by Trudeau. A hard one into the boards there. Another penalty to the Pacers. I would say they're playing the wrong game here. Just being honest, Nate goes in. Armstrong goes into the box. 7-10. Five minutes for boarding to Nate Armstrong.
Pacers penalty to number 21, Nate Armstrong. 5 minutes for boarding. Time of the penalty, 7:10. Armstrong, 5 minutes for boarding at 7:10.
33-32 at the end of the quarter for the Raptors. In case you're
that Kanye West trophy.
Yep. Yeah. That's what we'll be moving on. For more excitement after this. 14-8 right now in favor of Windsor. 7:10 left to go. Opportunity fading away for the Pacers here tonight. We'll be back again here on Saturday, a 7 o'clock game. We'll be broadcasting live. If you care to join us, mark that on your calendar. Of course, 4 o'clock on Sunday, we'll be back as well. And unless we see a win here tonight, Logan Scott fighting to get inside here. Windsor not allowing it. 5 seconds on a shot clock to go. Pressed hard through, got a shot off, but no goal. And the goalie for Windsor has gone to the bench. 6 out on Pacers with four guys in there now. Is there not a limit?
I'm not sure
what
the seating capacity is.
The seating capacity, something. 6:18, lots of yelling happening out there. 9:1 official, Mark Smith. Told to hit the showers by referee Mark Smith.
Number 9 got a game misconduct.
Game misconduct.
Dylan Malloy, number 9.
Another goal from Windsor. We are now 15-8 in this Junior B lacrosse game tonight. Coming to you live from the Point Edward Memorial Arena. Thanks to our friends at Tall Ships, Blue Water Border Fest, and Artscape, which will be at August 9th to the 11th. We'll be broadcasting live all weekend from the ships and from Blue Water Border Fest and Artscape. It's going to be an exciting weekend for sure. Back out to center floor. 6 minutes to go. And another goal. Makes it 16-8. It's Brett Barnes, formerly of the Pacers, got the goal, previous goal. Jenkins with the last goal there.
Jenkins, assisted by number 6,
so he's going to have to change real quick.
At 6:01.
With only three guys for the Pacers on the floor, this is going to be a difficult task. I'm not a betting man, but if I was. Another one going to the penalty box. Gavin McGregor Not afraid to fill the penalty box, Mark Smith. I don't pretend to understand it all the time. Windsor passing out front. Pacers head coach. Pacers head coach with a bench misconduct, you know what I mean. They got enough lights on that board to cover all the penalties for the Pacers. 20 seconds on the shot clock. Pacers holding on to the ball right now, looking to get inside. Number 6, Bert Thorpe. Jonathan Jenkins not letting him by. He'll just toss it away as the shot clock runs out. .430 to go. And there's another shot and a goal. 17-8 with 4:19 on the clock. Or 8, what did I say? Yeah, 18-8, sorry. He's trying. It seemed like in the second period things might turn around for the Pacers there as their passing seemed to improve. They got some goals. But I think, honestly, they just seem like they've written this part of it off with four guys in the penalty box. Really? Tell us how you really feel. Another shot and a goal coming from number 17. Chad Marintet. Sorry if I said that right.
Clippers goal, believe it or not, on the power play by number 3, Jack Dunn. Assisted by number 12.
Number 55, Peyton Cost. Peyton Cox. Tossed away. Mark Smith says, get out. Yep. Peyton Cox has gone to the showers. Smith is over talking to our gentlemen in the box, our scorekeepers. Rule trackers or penalty trackers. They're keeping busy tonight, that's for sure. Thanks for joining us here as we come with 4:10 on the clock. And we thank our sponsors again. We'll say hello to Active Ears. We appreciate Christine Fiji of Active Ears Hearing Centers here in Sarnia. And also Hughes Intelligence. And Fabian Jagu of the Co-Operators Insurance. Supporting us to be able to bring you this broadcast. Past games of the Pacers as well, also available on our website at tvsn.ca. An update on the Raptors game. not just Toronto, not just Ontario, but all of Canada going for the Raptors right now. Supporting them. 19-8. 3:30 to go. Zane Dalt with the last. It's not hard to have a power play when the half the team's in the penalty box. All right. Yeah, all right. I guess if you're, yeah. This name of the game, 3 minutes to go. And, yeah, that's quite a leap. To 38 for the Raptors, if you're interested.
Pacers fans, don't forget, we're back here on Saturday night, 7 o'clock, welcoming the Guelph Regals to town.
Guelph Regals, I said. Okay. Holding on tight. Number 12, Ethan Parkhouse. Didn't give up the fight. Some escapees from the penalty box. And still 3 minutes of penalty left in the box, though, for the Pacers. It's just too late, and another goal makes it 20-8. 20-8. There it is. .145 to go. Windsor with the ball, looking to score some more, and let's just sit right there. It's 21-8. Fastest game on 2 feet.
Clippers goal continuing on the power play by number 12, St. Dalton, assisted by number 10, Nathan Solaris, and number 3, Jack Dunn. The time of the goal, 1:50.
Back out to center floor, last minute of play here. Pacers with the ball. 45 seconds to go. 21-8. We thank you for joining us for this broadcast of Junior B Lacrosse. Let things roll away here. And that will end this game. Final score, 21-8 is the final score tonight. The Pacers fall very hard to the Windsor Clippers, 21-8. We thank you for watching, and we thank you for being a part of the lacrosse world. And we hope you'll come back and join us. We'll be here again on Friday at 7 o'clock broadcasting as the Pacers host Guelph. And then we'll be back here again on Sunday, 4 o'clock, broadcasting our final broadcast, likely. We want to thank you so much for joining us. Check us out at tvsn.ca for Pacer replays and everything else we do here at the Video Show Network. I've been your host, David Burrows. Thanks, everybody. until next time, bye for now. We'll be right back.